correspondent Kate Baldwin. Brianna, what are the real obstacles here? I mean, is this all about taxes? Because we heard John Boehner just moments ago here on the show saying that this isn't political.
No, and it certainly does have to do with tax increases, Randy. Democrats want to see some tax increases if they're going to give so much on spending cuts to priorities and programs that mean so much to them. They and the White House want to see something that they can say that they've also, if they're squeezing all Americans, that they're squeezing corporations, that they're squeezing wealthy Americans. But it isn't just about taxing, Ben. That's what Republicans say.
And isn't the president offering to defer taxes till 2013? I mean, presumably when the economy's on some sounder footing?
This was an interesting detail in his press conference earlier that we heard. He was saying we're not talking about imminent tax increases. We're talking about things that would go into effect down the road in 2013. I think
President and Speaker Boehner both, at least it seems this way, at the mercy of their rank and file, really, when it comes to this, you know, big historic agreement.
Well, they both say that to some extent, and they've both acknowledged again today that it's going to take both Democrats and Republicans, despite the fact that Republicans have a majority in the House and can, if they all agree, can push through many pieces of legislation. But they both acknowledge today that this is going to take a bipartisan effort, bipartisan votes to push this through. That's because there are elements of both party, some conservatives, some members of the Tea Party caucus, and on the other side, some very progressive liberal Democrats that are not going to vote for this because of their various reasons. I mean, we have some in the team saying they will not vote to raise the debt ceiling no matter what. And some liberals say if Medicare and Social Security are on the table at all, they're not going to vote for it at all. So that's why you're hearing the president talk about in his press conference, Randy, that he's willing to take some significant heat from his party in order to get a deal done. I asked John Boehner that same question, if he was willing to take that similar heat. And he said that he knows that there's going to be a lot. This is very tough politically, that they both need to come to an agreement in order to push this through. But he remained very firm today, as well as Majority Leader Cantor, that no tax hikes are on the table. And that's where they're remaining firm at the moment.
It seems, Kate, the only thing that both sides really agree on is that they will hammer out a deal. That's what they say. But I mean, remind us, if you would, about this this political calendar. When do we need this deal by?
It almost seems a little counterintuitive, because everyone seems to agree on one thing, that they need to get this deal done in time to raise the debt ceiling by August 2nd, the deadline set by the Treasury. But in the very next breath, you will hear from Republicans as well as, you know, Democrats saying that, but we won't vote to raise the debt ceiling if X or if Y. What I've heard from people here, and people have said it publicly, is that a deal really needs to get struck probably by the end of this week. July 22nd was a date that the president had thrown out there, because it does take time to draft legislation and get it passed through both chambers of Congress to get it to the president's desk in time for it to be signed by August 2nd. We're hearing today, if we know anything out of today, it seems that both sides are possibly more dug in than ever on their sticking points. And the big sticking point, Randy, and this is no surprise to anyone, seems to be the issue of taxes at this point, Randy.
Yeah, and Brianna, I want to get back to you. The president vowing to meet with lawmakers every day until a deal gets done. I mean, do deals really get done in meetings like these, or are these just photo ops meant to keep the pressure on, let the American people know that their legislators are working for them?
Randy, I think a lot of it is a photo op for sure, that says we're keeping the pressure on, and also, hey, look, we're doing something. We understand something needs to be done, and we're here working very hard. What you don't see in a photo op that is so important is the behind the scenes staff level discussions. The people who are they're sort of very entrenched in the policy, and they understand the fine details. They're the ones who are getting a lot of the work done. But I think the constant meetings day after day and sort of holding out until the last minute, we've seen this in other negotiations, this is giving both sides an opportunity to say, you know what, we fought till the bitter end, and this was the best deal that we could get. But it's certainly scary as you march toward an August 2nd deadline, when the ramifications of a default would be not just here in the U.S., but also global in economic in ramifications.
Yeah, certainly. Brianna Keeler, Kate Baldwin, thank you so much. Appreciate it. Our sound effect.